have a lot of programs, we do a lot of things, but the most important ministry we have brought to Kingstree and Williamsburg County is the ministry of our presence. We made it a pact when we first moved here that that would be our main ministry, that we will be present to people. We will be present to the neighbors. We will be present to the church. We will be there. We will be in those circles of people where we needed to be.
When I first remember sisters coming here, my first thoughts was, wow, they're going on Thorn Avenue. This is the roughest place in Williamsburg County and Kingstree. I thought it was crazy.
Williamsburg County is the poorest county in the state, and the state, South Carolina, is one of the poorest in the nation. And so there's an awful lot of need here.
We're Franciscan sisters, and so we have that mandate of our Father Francis of go repair my house. And so, you know, go repair my house doesn't mean from the old church to the synagogue or the new building that we put up, but the house of the people of God. Go repair, you know, misconceptions. Go repair prejudices.
The sisters have crossed the two barriers, the racial and religious barriers. They united all of them. It's incredible, absolutely incredible, if you knew what it was like before then.
There's a certain sense of fulfillment that I have experienced in knowing that, you know, we are assisting these people, you know, we are assisting with feeding the poor and, you know, helping the oppressed. It is a very rewarding experience being here in Kingstree.
Well, like my cousin next door, she was saying that it makes the community feel safer now, mm-hmm. You know, because we had a lot of stuff going on around here, mm-hmm. Break-ins down the street and stuff, but it's much safer. You know, a lot of people have a lot of respect for them.
Our ministry, when we first came here, we thought would be to the people of Thorn Avenue, the people around us. And as the years went on, we realized that there's more to this than just, you know, what we were doing.
That's the almost unbelievable thing in the rural South, to see the cooperation rather than the competition between churches, and to see old biases and worries pushed aside to do the work of God and be the light of Christ in the world. That's the thing that really and truly is amazing and a blessing to us all, to learn something really about Christianity, to be able to work together.
Until then, only the Catholic Church, as small as it is, served the Blessed Angela meal. And they did it once a month, and they were the only people. Other churches started getting involved. Today, we have 11 different churches in the community who serve a Blessed Angela meal once a month.
Everybody loves the sisters, everybody. I could name just about every church in this community that is involved with the sisters in one way or the other. There's the after school program, and you've got volunteers from, you know, every walk of the community, every church.
A lot of kids from the community get involved, and they keep a lot of them off the streets. It always something to do. Homework program is great. So I love it. I hope they never leave.
We've had a couple from our little town here in the homework program when we were working with them coming up. See, a couple of them have gone through and actually have graduated from college. Now, you know, that's great to see a product of your establishment going that far.
They have kind of cleaned up the neighborhood. Like I said before, you know, they inspire me to keep up my yard and keep up my house and carry myself in a certain way, because I take pride in our community, and I think it trickled down and starting from now.
But within this community, there are loving and caring people who work at our side with us. There's no way humanly possible that we alone could do this work.
Really believe in just being with the people and let them know we're here for them, and they are here for us. Mm-hmm. To me, that's the perfect church.